This is a multi-purpose trail in Alum Creek State Park. It is off Africa Road on the east side of the reservoir. This is my first time hiking this trail, so I don't know if it's all grass or if it actually eventually turns into a dirt or gravel trail. Can't say. There's three different lengths. Excuse me. There's a 1 mile loop. There's a 2 point some odd mile loop. And then there's a 3 point some odd mile loop. You can shorten your walk up or you can do the whole thing. I am going to do the 3 point, I think like 3.2 and then the 2.3. I'm planning on doing both of them. I'm gonna assume you do not come back out the same way, because as I was entering, it had a sign that said one way to enter, and then there's another one where you're exiting. So even though this is a loop, somewhere it breaks up to where you don't come back out the same spot you went in. It's not far from it, just a few feet, but difference. Okay, I just passing people going out, so I guess one direction doesn't really apply, which I didn't really think it would. But anyway, I asked them, and they said this whole trail is grass. And that could be an all right thing. I prefer dirt or gravel, because less chance of getting ticks. That's just my opinion. Another thing about grass trails that I don't really care for They're usually wider because they get the tractors back here to cut the grass, which means you're walking in the sun a lot. For myself, my preference when I take a walk in the woods, I actually like to be in the woods and under tree cover, not out in the open sun. But we all have our preferences. Any walk out in the woods is a good, nice walk. There's another separation here. I don't see a sign say which way to go. So I want to stay on a larger loop. I'm going to continue to stay to the right. I'm going to assume these are like parts just connecting the loop together in the middle. So we'll just continue this way. Okay, what I was going to say, is this the first time I've ever seen a stop sign on the hiking trail. What are we stopping for? Alright. It's just right over there. Oh, no, actually right there. Where I went in at. Park's right over there. So right there, that's where we went in. Where I was telling you about the enter, and see the sign there says, do not enter. One way over there. So, I'm gonna assume back there where I took a right, they said the whole thing is grass, so I'm gonna assume that's not part of the trail. So I'm gonna assume back there where I took a right, I went to the left. Where I was saying it's probably just a connector between the loop. It would be nice if these trails were better marked so you know which way is which. So it just let people guess which way to go. Okay, we're coming back to where at a little intersection. Came off from the left there, and I went straight or veered to the right. Thinking this way it was just, like I say, a connection between the loop. This is the only other alternative, so this way has to take us somewhere. must not be very far from Africa Road, because I can hear the traffic out there. I imagine you probably can't see the cameras picking it up, the phone. I saw also that there's a bridle trail out here, which appears to go all the way around the reservoir. It's something like 38 miles. I don't know if that trail's tore up from the horses, and if you're allowed to walk it or run it, it's tore up by the horses. Probably isn't the best thing to run. Twisting an ankle. Got bug spray with me just in case I need it. So far I haven't had to pick any ticks off me or had any serious problems with the insects. I hiked a trail a few weeks ago down at Patel Darby Creek. It was a grass trail. I got to spray myself. I was so infested with ticks. I think it's probably the worst I ever have had. I was ticking ticks off me like crazy. I left the trail, didn't finish hiking because it was just too much. I figured I'll save it for another day. I bet I probably picked a good 2 dozen ticks off me that day. As long as I hear traffic on my right and the reservoir is on my left, I know I'm heading north, which is a good sign. So now this is what I like in the trail. Dirt, primitive. This is my kind of trail right here. Yes, it can get muddy after a rain, but scared to get a little dirty, maybe hiking's not for you. That is definitely dry. No water in that. Other than the two people that I came across when I first came out here and into the trail, I haven't seen anybody else back here. I believe I'm going counterclockwise around this loop. Heading north right now, and then when we start to loop back, we'll be closer to the reservoir, heading back towards the parking lot. So maybe most of the people are walking the same direction counterclockwise. If that's the case, then I probably won't run into too many. I believe the larger loop, not counting the 1 mile loop, which is right, pretty much up near the parking lot. But I believe the first big loop was the 3 point some odd miles. And then after that was the smaller loop, which is 2 point some odd miles. I'm gonna assume we're still on the bigger loop. Eventually we're gonna hit a crossroads, cross path, do the 2 point some odd miles, which is the second big loop. Here after the road, but now instead of being on my right, I'm carried off in the distance behind me. It's that curve back there, just curved to the left. And you notice that when we're walking, we curved to the left a good 90 degrees. That's why I'm thinking we should pretty soon hit the second loop to do a longer walk. And that's my plan, is to walk the whole thing. This is the first bench I've seen. And it looks like we're at a crossroad here again. We've got a sign, a little covered with brush, but I'm gonna assume we're gonna go to the right. Okay, we are at location C, which puts us right there. Okay, so this is a big loop. This is 3.6. And then we're gonna go out here and do this one also, which is another 2.2. So we're at C, and it looks like C goes to sharp to the left. So I don't know where the right goes to then. So we're gonna follow what the sign says and go to the left, and not too far, we should hit the yellow off to the right. So maybe this might be a service access road or something, I don't know. I see something way down there. That may be service. There's a vehicle. Okay. That's probably service access. Actually, we got some people down here. We're only gonna go until the trail goes off to the right, but I'm gonna shut off because I don't like putting people on my videos. Okay. I can see the reservoir up there through the trees. And here is the trail going off to the right that the sign showed us, which should be now the yellow. And now we're gonna follow this one. Doesn't look like this one's been cut. Grass has been cut as recent as the other one. So if these two loops, one is 3.6, the other is 2.2, that'll give us about 5.8, a little under 6 miles to walk around this whole thing. That's not a bad walk. Little sign right here. Yeah. That's the first one of them I've actually seen. But it is pretty clear which way to walk. People throwing parts of a stove out here. People come out here and throw anything. Though that doesn't mean somebody threw it out here. This could be from got a brain block now. Flood plain. And reservoir flood. Stuff can wash wherever from wherever. Most likely that's probably how that got there. Flood waters. I'm noticing this loop here, the 2.2 one, so the yellow loop, is not as maintained as the, I think it was red, the 3.6 one. And we had that down tree, then I ended up walking through an area where overgrowth on a trail that I basically had to push my way through. Just like look at this here. Yeah, this is definitely not as maintained as much as the larger loop. Why? I don't know. Look at this. Yeah, much longer this year is going to be closed up. Pretty close to it now. I believe we may now be at the farthest most point north on the yellow loop. And it appears we're now heading towards the reservoir with the road behind us. And if that is the case, then we should be turning, slowly curving to the left, start heading back. Like I said, this is my first time on this trail, so. Yes, sir. That's a lawnmower that I hear, or what? There's something running off in the distance. I believe my calculations are correct. I believe now the reservoir is on our right. Half the road is now on our left. And we are on the loop back. So now we should be heading south. Well, we are heading south. And there she is. I would say that is an accident waiting to happen. People down there. I don't know if there's a beach down there, or boat ramp, or what is it? Fly back in here. Do not know my butterflies. Monarch and there's the viceroy, which are really similar. We should be just about done with this 2.2 loop. And pretty soon should be merging back into the 3.6, heading back to the parking lot. One of the very few ravines I've crossed in this trail. Dry as can be. Reservoir out there. There's one other ravine I went through that I wasn't recording. That one and this one are probably the two biggest climbs on this hike. So like I said, it's a pretty easy trail. So far, since I've been hiking, I caught two guys, and a guy and a girl, and another girl. That's it. That's all I've encountered out here since I've been out here. A total of five people on three different occasions. Maybe it's just too hot today. People are in the water instead of in the woods. I think it's supposed to be about 88 today. High humidity, dew point. Keep hearing that thunder off in the distance. All right, I turned around. See, down there's a lake. And right down there, just to the right, is where we come off of 2.2. And decided to come back up this way. And here we go. And here's the sign. All right, we are at D, which is right there. See, that's what we just come off of, 2.2. Now, that's where we were at before when we turned left and then went all the way around through here. Now we're here, and we're going to follow this all the way back. So we get back to the parking lot. And another bench. I sort of wonder if they leave that stuff on the trail to keep people from coming back here, driving their vehicles back here. There's bench number two. You probably have to say, okay, this is 3.6. Now we're heading back, so it's 1.8. And that doesn't work that way. And it's raining. Interesting right here. It's more like a stream bed. Really, water runoff. And maybe after good rain, you actually may get some water. I mean, it looks pretty muddy. Okay. Still raining a little bit. Nothing heavy. Look at my phone, I got left 57% left. I think that's quite enough to get us back. I'm just not going to use my phone out here in this rain. I don't want it to get wet and ruined. I don't have my waterproof case on it. Okay. It finally let up rain. It rained. And it rained hard for a while. And I was beginning to wonder if it was going to stop. I'm soaked. Because there is nowhere to get out in the rain. I took a few covers under trees when we were in the woods. It helped some. But I just kept going. I was wet. So, what was hiding under the trees going to do? I was already wet. We should be almost back to the parking lot now. I see some boats still out there on the lake, but I see many of them heading back to the ramp. So they're coming back in. That may be rain, or just water blowing off the trees. I'm gonna imagine we're gonna come back out in the same spot we came in. Oh, here we go. We are at F. Right here. If we go that way, I'm gonna go this way. To the right. Which we're bringing back out to A. Which is, let me get it in here in view. We're at F right here. I'm gonna turn to the right. And that'll bring us back out to A, which is where we started at. And here we are. We are half completed. See, it says one way, stay on trail. I think I showed you that earlier. I showed you the do not enter sign over there. So this is it. We are back to boat ramp. Did a 6.8 mile hike.